everybody. I'm Therese, and this is Pilates Mat class. If you're new to Pilates, just let me walk you through what you're going to need. You really don't need anything at all, except maybe a towel or a mat to put down on the floor. You don't even need sneakers. So barefoot or sock feet or sneakers if you want. If you happen to have some light hand weights or even some water bottles or some soup cans, you could use those. And usually we use something to squeeze between the inner thighs or in between the ankles, like a little Pilates ball or a Pilates ring. But once again, you don't have to use anything at all. You could use like a little small pillow, or if even you had a playground ball that you could squeeze in between your inner thighs, you could use that. But again, don't feel like you have to use anything at all. So again, if you're new to Pilates, this is all about the core. We're going to work our abs, our back, our hips, and our buttocks. But really, it's a full body workout. So you'll feel arms and legs working, you feel a little bit of your heart rate getting up, but it's not going to be a real cardio workout. We're mostly going to be laying down on the floor. We're going to be strengthening the muscles that surround the joints. So it's great for injury prevention. We're working on flexibility and really just working from the inside out. So you're going to feel really nice and strong and tight from those deepest ab muscles. So we'll hit all those layers of abs. And get you really strong from the inside out. So I'm going to put on a little music, and we're going to start laying down on the floor. So you can come to laying down on your back, stretching out your arms and legs nice and long. So just bring the arms overhead, or if that's not safe, on your shoulders. You could instead place the thumbs right under the rib cage and the pinky fingers right above the hips. All we're going to do is decompress the spinal segments and then set up a neutral spinal position and then practice our breathing. So laying down, reaching long, lifting our right arm and our right leg just so it hovers an inch above the floor. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, extend the leg forward from the hip, and then reach long from below the rib cage towards the head. One more breath. Inhale, exhale, reach the hip away towards your feet and reach the rib cage towards your fingers. Keep it long, place it back on the mat. Maybe it feels a little longer than the other side. Switch the other arm and leg. Lift the left arm and left leg just an inch above the floor. Inhale, exhale, extend long. Feel really wide between that bottom rib and hip. Really long. One more breath, inhale, exhale, just reach. Like I'm pulling on your fingers, pulling on your toes. Place it back on the floor. Keep that length. We're always thinking long and Pilates. Then we're gonna set up our S-shaped curve in our back, or what we call our neutral spinal position. So open wide across the collarbones, slide the shoulders away from the ears, slightly tuck the chin, press the rib cage down. Make sure we're not popping the rib cage. There should just be a little small space between the low back and the mat. If you slide your hand underneath that, just feel that small lumbar curve so we're not flattening or arching the low back. And again, same thing with the back of the neck. Feet just as wide as the hip bones with the toes up to the sky. And we use what we call forced exhalation breathing to help fire our abs and Pilates. So to practice that, we'll place our hands on our rib cage, take a big breath in through the nose. You can stay laying down. I'm just gonna sit up so you can see me a little better. Inhale, breathe into the nose, in through the nose, into the ribs in the back. Exhale, blow out through your mouth like you're blowing out a birthday candle 3 feet across the room. Again, inhale through the nose, laterally expanding the ribs side to side. Exhale, blow out through your mouth. So feel that really tightening up in those deep ab muscles when you blow out through your mouth. That transverse abdominis, it's shaped kind of like a corset, wraps around, and it will help protect your back, and we want to engage it through our exercises. It only works with that diaphragm breathing muscle, so you have to blow out through your mouth to get it going. Going on to some ab curls. Again, you can squeeze something in between the thighs or just have your legs as wide as your hips, but think about squeezing through the inner thighs. Grabbing our hand weights, so just arms overhead or sliding the hips. Inhale to prepare, exhale, come up. Squeeze those legs towards each other. Reach up and forward. Take a long path if it suits your shoulders. When we reach overhead, we're only going to where our shoulders feel happy, so we're not straining our shoulders, and where we can keep that neutral spinal position. So make sure the ribs don't pop up while the arms go overhead. You don't have to touch the floor. It depends on your whole body. Making it smooth and flowing. It doesn't have to be high off the floor. We're thinking about sliding our ribs towards our feet to pull up, so we're not leading with our chin or pulling with our neck. Well done. Bend the right elbow, place the left hand down on a low diagonal with the palm down, and then come up, press across. You can use a hand weight in that right hand, but you can also do this just with your hand alone. Smooth. Squeeze the ball or just squeeze through the inner thighs. Four more. Four. Three. Two. Final time. Switch out to the other side. Bend that left elbow. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, come up straight. Press across. So we're working the middle abs, our oblique abdominals that assist us in rotation and lateral flexion of our spine. Well, they're responsible for it. Anyway, four more. Three. Feel free to cut down the repetitions. It's not necessary to do 8 or 16 of everything. So if your neck starts to feel strained or just feel really fatigued, take a break. Bring the arms wide at shoulder height. Press the insoles of the hips. We want to make sure we're maintaining that proper form. And what happens is when our abs get tired, sometimes we start pulling with our head, neck, and shoulders. So if you start to feel strained in your neck, just take a total break. Give your body a little quick rest, and then you can pick it right back up when you're ready. Nice job. So either we can come into some ab curls again with or without the weights if our back is sensitive. Otherwise, reverse curls. Our fingers come soft behind the head. We exhale with the shoulders off the floor. We're going to keep the chest lifted and just move the legs in and out. So bringing them right over the hips. Knees come right over the hips. Inhale, take them out. Exhale, pull it in. Keep the ribs and hips close together. We call that our rib-to-hip connection in Pilates. We're making sure we're not arching that low back. And if we start to separate the ribs to the hips, that's when you get that arch in the back. Our feet do not have to touch the floor. They could go out just a few inches. So we want to make sure we're feeling safe in our back, no pain, and that we're not coming out of alignment with our spine. There's no kicking off the floor, so we're barely tapping if our feet are going to the floor, and there's no swinging. So we take out the momentum and really use control to pull those legs in using our abs and our forced breath. And we focus more on going out than really crunching in. So we're not bringing our knees all the way to our chest, which you might do in other classes, but in Pilates, we're always thinking about extending away from ourselves a little bit from our midline. Bring it out, exhale, pull it in. From our trunk anyway. Nice job. And then lower it down, release a little ball or pillow. If you're using one, hold on behind the thighs, circle out the knees, or rock side to side with the knees. Maybe gently move the head side to side. And anytime you need to, it can come back to this position. Circle the other way. So if you need to take a break, again, if your neck's getting tired, just take a break, bring it to knees to chest hug, and then pick it back up. We're gonna go into some knee changes. Single leg stretch, bring the knees in, exhale, bring the head off the floor, extend the left leg long. So we keep the shoulder square, we'll cross our left hand below our right knee, right hand above our right ankle, chin tucked, head up, switch out the knees. Keeping that long leg on a higher diagonal if we're healing our back, or we could take it lower if we don't have any back sensitivity. Again, reach like you're trying to touch your toe all the way across the room to the other side of the wall. Good job. You got it. Eight more here. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and last time. Lowering down. Tricep reach. So this position is kind of like we have frog legs, and we're gonna add some rowing arms to it. So one knee comes to tabletop, the other knee comes to tabletop. It looks a little funny, but we're gonna work our hips, our thighs, our abs, and our tris all at the same time. So the heels come together, but not the toes. Our knees are spread out wide. Our feet stay together the whole time. Our hands come palm down with the elbows out wide and our thumbs up near our armpits, either with your hand weights or just your hands. So you're gonna row, pressing forward with the arms, extend the legs, curl up. Bring the knees and the elbows wide, lowering the head. Exhale, extend the legs right over the hips as we curl and press, or come into a V-sit if you don't have any, again, issues with the back. Zip the legs together like they're one leg as we extend. Four more. Feel the back of the arms working. Three, two, you got it. Last one, and then lowering down. Letting the legs go out long or staying with bent knees like we did before. When we bend the knees, it reduces some of the strain on the back, so you can stay with those bent knees. Arms alone or hand weights over the head, or change up the arms, slide the hands to hips or fingers behind the head. We'll inhale to prepare, exhale, come up, but not all the way to sitting. So here we're working those six-pack abs, our rectus abdominis. And we want to keep what we call the Pilates scoop. So we're keeping our belly scooped out by only coming up partial way. If we come all the way up, we start to engage the back and the hips more. And we want to just really keep firing those six-pack abs. If your back's not happy, bend the knees. And releasing the weights, extending the right arm on a high diagonal with the palm up, left hand palm down, bring the right arm over the shoulder, come up straight, press across. Working those obliques. Nice and smooth. These are our middle abs, which if I didn't mention, they are responsible for our rotation and lateral flexion of the spine. Four more, four. Three, two, turning off our strong shoulders. Other side, bringing the left arm up, come up straight, press across. So in Pilates, we're trying to inhibit some of our stronger, bigger muscles and really recruit the core to pull us up and to initiate the motions. Three more. Two, and last time, lower it down. Well done. Bend the knees, feet on the floor in front of the knees, but as wide as the hip bones. Going into some small range of motion circles, we're gonna extend the right leg to the sky, point through the ankle so we don't cramp up the toes. We're gonna focus on really anchoring ourselves so nothing moves but the leg from the hip. The bottom leg can be bent or extend it long if it feels okay with your back and you want more of a challenge. Inhale and exhale each circle, just taking it out. Five, four, three, two, one. Pause, go the other way. Try not to rock through our midsection. Keeping that powerhouse nice and tight and still. Two more, always a little micro bend in the kneecap so we're not locking it out. Shake out that foot. Bring that other leg up and then draw a circle on the ceiling. And it could be on the, you know, diagonal with your leg. It just depends on your hamstrings and your hips. Five, four, three, two, one. Pause, go the other way for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Last time, shake out your foot. Bring both knees in towards the chest. Moving into a double leg stretch. Our straight leg changes. Curling up into upper ab curl. Right leg to the sky, other leg straight above the floor, and just scissor out those legs, two sets of eight. Eight, seven, six, five, you got it. Four, three, two, feels wonderful on the hamstrings. Eight more times, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and last time. Lower it down. Double arm and leg stretch. I can find what I did with my hand weights. Oh, they're over my head. We'll go into double arm leg stretch. So this one, you can either do it with your head and chest down, or you can do it in upper arm curl. So I'll show both ways. Knees come in and we're squeezing our legs together to engage our pelvic floor muscles. Hands are hand weights over the shins. Inhale, exhale, reach the arms over the shoulders and the legs right over the hips. Bring the arms wide, circle them around as we bring the knees in. Inhale, exhale, reach straight up to the sky. So once again, we're focusing on that midsection, staying nice and tight and anchored to the floor so it's not rocking around and shifting at all. So if you feel good there, stay right there. If you need more, bring it up in an upper ab curl. And once again, we're only moving the arms and the legs. So notice that the head and the shoulders are not going backwards. As I reach back, just the arms are going to the ears and the legs are going out on a diagonal. And it can be a higher diagonal if that feels better on your back. But we're not lowering the head, neck, and shoulders. Keeping that midsection anchored to the floor. Reach, circle it around, bring knees in, exhale, extend. Two more, two. Last one, lower down and release. Grab some water if you need it. I'm super thirsty from talking. So it's a really fun way, Pilates is a really fun way to do your core work. Well, I think it's fun anyway. It gets easier too, so give yourself at least 10 classes to get used to it, because it does take a while to for your body to get used to. Let's go into some obliques again. So we'll go into a crisscross with bent knees. So both knees come to chest, fingers soft behind the head, exhale, lift the shoulders off the floor, extend the left leg long, and then twist your rib towards your left rib towards your right thigh. Switch the knees, twist. And again, we're not pulling on the head or neck. We're also keeping those elbows away from the face and just turning our rib cage, reaching, lengthening that extending leg really far away from us. If we want more, we can take our opposite hand and reach it across that opposite thigh to get a little deeper into that twist. Reach, reach, nice. Eight more, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and last time. Move into a shoulder bridge. I might have said we were doing that before and then forgot, but we are gonna go to a bridge. Unless you don't want to back bend or be upside down. If you have a little pillow or a little ball or a Pilates ring, you can use it in between your thighs. Otherwise, just feet as wide as hip bones and feet right under knees. Keep your hand weights close by or your water bottles or soup cans. Inhale to prepare. Exhale, slowly peeling our hips up off the floor. Articulating through the spine to get up. A little different than our yoga bridge, our shoulders are square here. In yoga, we tend to kind of walk our shoulder blades a little closer together, but here we're just a little square across the chest. We're gonna bring our hips down, inhale, exhale, lift up, squeeze the buttocks. Dip the hips, exhale, come up, squeeze the buttocks, squeeze that little ball, or just squeeze through the inner thighs. If we want a little more, we could add some chest flies. So hands palm up. Lowering the hips, then exhale, lift the hips, close the arms together over the chest. Six more, five, four, you got it, head is still even though I'm looking at the camera, really trying not to move your neck. Two more, last time, and then going into chest press with this, lower the hips, hands palm forward over the chest, and as we lift the hips, we press up with the arms. You could use a body bar too, anything you have. Around the house. Four more. Three, squeeze. Two, last time. Release the weights, hands down by the side, and we're gonna roll down very slowly. Once again, we're trying to bring our vertebrae down one vertebrae at a time. So rolling down from the top of the head to the low back. Try not to just drop. Coming to our tailbone last, releasing that little ball or pillow if you have one or ring. Walk the feet out a little further, cross the right ankle over the left thigh, right hand between the window of the legs, holding behind the left thigh, taking that upside down pigeon stretch. Feel that nice stretch through the hips, the buttocks, the piriformis. Chin slightly tucked. never forcing or straining, but if you need a deeper stretch, you can bring the bottom knee in a little closer to get the deeper buttock stretch. We can open that top thigh wider to get a deeper hip stretch. And then when we're ready, switching to the other side, left ankle over right thigh, lift the foot off the floor, left hand comes through the legs. So instead of wrapping both arms around the outside of both legs, we just take the left hand on the inside of the right thigh and the right hand on the outside of the right thigh. So we're just clasping behind that one leg. Do that wonderful stretch. Sometimes we don't know where we're tight until we come to our exercise class and move it and stretch it. Always breathing. We need heat and breath to stretch. And then lowering down. So we're gonna go into a double arm and leg stretch. No, I think we already did, I can't remember. Let's go into some more ab curling. So I taught a lot of classes today, so I can't remember. They start to blend together. One knee comes to tabletop, the other knee comes to tabletop. Arms go overhead or slide to our hips. Inhale, then exhale, curl up. So just like we did with our feet on the floor earlier. If you're not comfortable with the knees up, they could go right back on the floor like when we started class. So wherever you want to be. So either feet on the floor or knees at table. Blow out through the mouth. Try not to pull with the chin or the shoulders to get up. Again, we want to slide the ribs down. Well done. And then release that. Let's take the right hand high diagonal, come up, press across to the other side. Both shoulders lifting. Nice, long, smooth motions. Five more. Four. Three, you got it. Two. One, switching to the other side for eight. Seven. Five more strong. Four. Three. Two. One. Well done. Release that. So I'm going to show some options for double leg hip circles. We can either do this laying flat on the floor with either bent knees circling to the right and then circling to the left, trying not to rock through our midsection. We could also do that with long legs, which is a little more pressure on our low back. Or we could do those same options with the legs, but come up onto our elbows in what we call elbow scoop, stacking our shoulders and our elbows and aligning our hands with our elbows, making sure we're not sinking into the hips and or into the low back or the chest, and that our abs are nice and tight. So you don't want to kind of slouch here. You're lifting up, chest is lifted, low back's lifted, tummy's tight, and then one knee comes up, the other knee comes up. We can circle out our knees here, going one way and then the other, or we could take long legs, going right, forward, left, and back to center, and then reversing left, forward, right, pulling it back to center. And there's an inhale and an exhale on each repetition. We're squeezing the legs together as if we have one leg. Feel free to lay flat on the floor with that head down. So if you don't like this on your shoulders or elbows or your back, you can lay flat. Excuse me. If you're not feeling challenged, we could come up long-armed and do the same thing. It's a little harder not to kind of sink into those shoulders. If it bothers your hips or your low back, you know, just skip it. So always listening to our body. If it's not a good exercise for you, anytime you want, you can come back to an ab curl or a knees to chest hug. Once you're even on both sides, either bring both knees to chest from laying on the floor, or one knee comes down, the other knee comes down. If you're laying down, rock up to sitting, and we're going to come to the end of our mat and take our hands behind us and do some leg lifts. Bend the left knee if you're healing your back. Otherwise, both legs can be long, shoulders down, soft kneecap. Pull that right leg up, but pull it up with the abs and the breath. Try not to just swing it up. Four more. Three, two, one. Switching to the other leg. Eight. Seven, six, five more, four, three, two, one. So we could do that again with our hands on the floor, or we could lift our arms to a T. Another option is to come into an incline plank. which you're not going to want to do if you have shoulder, wrist, or elbow issues. So feel free to keep your buttocks on the floor. Otherwise, hands come underneath the shoulders with the fingers pointing towards the body, and we can lift up and do our leg lifts here. Inhaling, the exhale, right leg lifts. So this is our leg pull in an incline plank, but you can do it like we just did. Four more times, four, three, two, one, other side, eight, seven, five more strong, four, three, two, final time, and then lower it on down. Coming into a seated straddle position, legs go out wide. Feel like you zipped up a zipper under the belly button, tighten the tummy, feel like there's a string on the top of the head pulling our spine up to the sky. Our chest is wide, so we're smiling across the collarbone. We don't want to round our shoulders and kind of frown. And our arms coming to a T, rotating to the right, inhaling, coming center, exhale, go to the other way. So we want that spine nice and long. We're turning from below the rib cage. We're not leading with our head or with our shoulders. So everything's moving in unison from below the rib cage to the top of the head. If you're not liking that twisting on your back, you could instead do a little dive forward, spine stretch forward. So pick your spot. Some people don't like the twisting in Pilates. It just depends what you have going on with your back. If you have some injury to your back and you're not supposed to twist, change it up. You can take out the twisting completely. So we're gonna come into a nice lateral stretch. If you don't like the legs like this, they can stay long-legged or just crisscross applesauce legs. Otherwise, just stack the feet to their left, hold left hand to left ankle, and then we're bending. So we can either bend with our right hand on our hip, or we can take a nice big rainbow arm and bring it overhead, come onto the forearm on the right side, and then lean the other way. This is called a mermaid stretch, but it can be a merman stretch too, so don't feel like it's only a female stretch. Remember, Pilates was invented by a man named Joseph Pilates in the 20s and 30s, and he really invented it to rehab incumbents in internment camp during the war. Swing it around. So it was invented by a man for a man, but this is called mermaid. He spent a lot of time on a boat coming over here to America from the other side of the water. So there's a lot of nautical themes in Pilates. Let's do six more like that. And then nice lateral bend. We're also working those obliques. Four more. Four. Nice to stretch it out. Three. Two. And one more. I forget which way we started, but we'll get it in both ways. Very well done. So scoot to the short end of the front of the mat, and we're going to come in to what we call our C-spine position and roll down our spine. So finding ourselves right on our sitting bones, arms come out long, you can bend your knees if you want. Inhale to prepare, exhale, drawing the navel towards the spine like you're doing a cat stretch. Slightly tugging the chin, and then rolling down slow, vertebrae by vertebrae. If you feel like you're going to kind of collapse and hit your head, bend the knees, hold on behind the thighs. It gets a little trickier the lower we go. So control that roll down. Nice. So we did our crisscross earlier with bent knees. We're gonna do it with scissor legs. This could be a little harder on the back. So if you wanna go back to that bent knee crisscross, if that felt good to you, you can do that instead of the scissor legs, the long legs. Knees come in, inhale, exhale, lift the shoulders off the floor, right leg to the sky, left leg straight above the floor, fingers soft behind the head, and we're twisting towards that leg closest to us. Switching legs, twist, exhale, twist, rib to hip, rib to hip. We could add that opposite arm extension across like we did earlier if we want, or just keep the fingers right behind the head. Reach, good. A little faster for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and final time. And bring it back down. Well done. So the Pilates 100. Get water anytime you want. I'm super duper thirsty. It's been so hot this week, which I love, but we have to make sure we stay hydrated, right? So the Pilates 100 can be a little bit tricky on your neck if you're not used to doing it. So if your neck gets tired, I want you to just put your head down. Don't feel like you have to keep your head up the whole time for this one. Some exercises that want your head up just helps to keep that middle back pushing into the floor. But this one, head can come down as long as your legs aren't pressed 90 degrees. So either feet on the floor out further than the knees. If you have a little ball or a pillow or a ring, you can place it in between the thighs. This is one option where you're here and we're paddling arms and we're breathing in and out. In through the nose, out through the mouth. If you want a little more, the knees could come to tabletop mat. And the other option is to come into parallel with the hips, extend the legs, either right over the hips or on a diagonal. This is harder on the back. So again, bent knees always a little safer on the back. So pick your spot wherever you want to be. I'm just going to go in the middle and hands down by the side. Exhale, lift the shoulders up. Paddle out the arms. We're going to breathe in through the nose for a count of five. Exhale through the mouth for a count of five and do it 10 times. Ready? Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze through the inner thighs, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five, six more. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. Two more. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, five. One more time. Inhale, two, three, four, five. And exhale, squeeze, two, three, four, and five. Beautiful job. Just lower that down. Bring the knees in. Surf out your knees. Move your head side to side. So like I said, that can be a little bit tricky on the neck if you're not used to doing it. It's just, like I said, when your abs get tired, sometimes we pull with the head, neck, and shoulders to compensate. So when you feel that, make sure you rest your head down. Arms to a T, taking a cross stretch, dropping your knees to one side, head and ribs look over the opposite shoulder. A little supine twist. And then bring it the other way. Knees go one direction, head and ribs look over the opposite shoulder. And then floating back to center. So we'll go into some abduction and adduction of our hips. And this can either be done single leg or double leg. You can add an ab crawl. You can keep your head right on the floor. So many variations. Pick whatever your body wants. So we can either bend the left knee, bring the right leg up, open the right leg, flex, point and close. Or we could do the same thing and add a little ab crawl with or without the hand weights. If you don't have any back sensitivity, you could do a straddle leg and do both legs at the same time. So let's get that going, either right leg only or both legs wide, feet or foot flex. Inhale to prepare, exhale, point and close. Maybe curl up, pressing up from the chest with the arms and the head. Six more, five, feel that beautiful stretch through your hips. Four, three, two, final time. So other leg, if you're doing single leg, you can be right here. You don't have to lift your head. You could lift just the arms, or you could just keep the arms down as well, just open and close, or do the double leg. If you want to change up the arms, reach them overhead. Inhale, open and flex. Exhale, point and close. Bring it up. Six, five, four, three, two, and final time. And then bring it down. Well done. So dolphin, it's a little different than a yoga dolphin, which is more like a forearm down dog. This one's kind of a reverse curl. So if you're healing your back, once again, You might want to skip it and just go right into some ab curls. Otherwise, we're bringing one knee to tabletop, the other knee to tabletop, fingers softly behind the head, inner thighs zipping together. Exhale, lifting the chest off the floor, extending the legs, flexing the feet in parallel. Dropping the legs forward just to where we can keep that rib-to-hip connection and that ribcage hidden. Exhale, point, pull the legs in. Extend and flex. Inhale, drop it down. Exhale, pull it in. We're barely touching behind the head. Head and shoulders are still up if we take the arms away. Take it down, just like a dolphin's tail. Blow out through the mouth. So the feel at that navel sinking towards our mat, towards our spine. Just four more times. Four, you don't have to go low with the legs. You can go out just a little bit, right? Three more strong. Three. Two. And as we squeeze the inner thighs together, almost like we're zipping up a zipper under the belly button, we're activating those pelvic floor muscles, which are also stabilizers. We use them all the time in Pilates. And then lower it down. Well done. Going into a body crunch. So this one a little different than our knee changes. We're going to curl up and down off the floor. So arms and legs go long. And we'll start just with the right leg coming in for eight. So we can either keep, well, you don't have to curl up. You can just keep that head down and bring the right knee in and out, like a little body crunch, or we can add that curl here, maybe add the hand weights. Stand that same leg and shoot the leg far away. Five more, five, oh, it's getting late. Four, having too much fun. Three, two, last time, switch the other side for eight. Seven, six, you got it, strong. Five, four more, three, two, final time. Bring it down. Either coming bent knee with the feet on the floor, knees at tabletop, or bring the legs up, bring the heels together and open up the hips. We call that Pilates V. So your heels are together but not the toes. And again, bent knees safer on your back. We'll ab curl here, come up, sliding ribs to hips. Six more. Four. Three. Two, you got it. Last time, bend the right elbow, come up straight, press across, working those middle abs. Six. Four. Three. Two. Other way for eight. Bend the left elbow, come up straight, press across. Six. Four more. Three. Bring the arms wide at shoulder height, back to those lateral reach arms. Five. Four. Three. Two. One. And then either back to ab curls or curl up, arms over the chest with the palms forward, weights are just, or you could have fingers behind the head here. Drop the legs forward and then bring the legs in, extend the arms here, making sure we have that nice neutral spine so we're not popping up in the rib cage and arching the low back. If you want a longer lever leg, that's harder, but arms can go to the ears. Just be careful, once again, we're not dropping the head and shoulders. And we're stopping right at the ears with the arms so we don't strain our neck. Bring it out. Exhale, pull it in without swinging. How about just three more? Three. Two. Final time. Lower down, you did it. Bring the knees in, step right out, move the head side to side. Working our back, so we work our abs, we need to work our back too. We'll do some lat pull downs. You can use just your arms alone. Again, if you have a body bar or some hand weights, even if you have a tube or a band, you could use it. Bringing the arms up over our chest, we're gonna come all the way up to sitting. Inhale to prepare, exhale, take a long path, reaching up and forward, finding our sitting bones and a long back. Bend the knees if that's more comfortable. Align the knuckles and the wrists so we don't hurt our wrists. And then pull the arms down behind the head. Six more. Six, five, four, three more strong. Two, one. Reach it up and then bring it to the chest and press. Six more. Five, four, three, two, last time. The arms to shoulder height. Roll down just a little bit. Rotate right, come center, rotate left. So once again, some people don't like that twisting of Pilates. If you don't, you could just do some bicep curls here instead. Otherwise, we're twisting, flexing the foot we're twisting towards, bringing our ribs with us when we twist. So we're not just swinging the shoulders. That'll pull out your back. We want to turn from those abdominals. So as we blow out all that stale air, we're turning our ribs. Head and shoulders are just coming along for the ride. Three more. Two. One more each way. Bring it center. Sit tall. Reach out. If you want to put the hand weights down, you can, but we're going to use them again. We'll do one more set. Exhale, we're going to roll down in C-spine position. So we're making our back look like a letter C as we draw our navel towards our spine, slightly tuck the chin, round that low back, and bring it down vertebrae by vertebrae, controlling the roll down, trying not to just drop at the end, bringing the arms overhead. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, come up. Take a long path up to sitting, finding our sitting bones and a long back. Make sure the knuckles aren't dropping behind the wrists. That's aligned. Bend the knees if that helps your back. Six more, five, four, three, got it, two, one, reach it out and then to the chest, pectoralis reach. Six more, six, four, I'm getting my sweat on, how about you? Three, two, one, bring the arms to shoulder height, exhale, roll down, twist to the right, flex the foot, come center, go the other way, or bicep curl, anything you want. Six more. Four, you got it. Three. Two. One more. Each way. Come on up. Reach it up. Scoop the belly. Round the low back. Slightly tuck the chin. Control as you roll down. Coming down vertebrae by vertebrae. If you feel like you're going to drop and hit your head, just release the weights. Bend the knees, hold on behind the thighs. And release that. Grab some water if you need it. We're gonna do a modified teaser and then I'll show a teaser. So be real careful with lifting up into a V-sit. So a teaser is basically coming up into a V-sit. That can be really a lot of spinal compression. If you already have some damage to your vertebrae, you're not gonna wanna lift the legs. You're gonna keep the feet right on the floor and just curl up. You're still gonna activate the abs, so don't feel like you're missing a thing. Don't worry, I'll show it. I'll walk you through. So when you're ready, come on down. So if I'm gonna roll into my hand weights, hit my head. So feet are on the floor, out further than the knees, and just legs hip width apart. And we're just gonna do this without anything in the hands. Bring the arms up, inhale to prepare. Exhale, slide ribs to hips, come all the way up to sitting. It's a little hard because I'm doing this kind of late at night. A little tired, it's past my bedtime actually. Roll it down, and then we'll try it again. So we're gonna bring the arms up, inhale, exhale, slide the ribs towards the hips to pull ourselves up, and then roll it down. So for me, this almost feels harder than doing a teaser. So really trying not to pull with the head, neck, and shoulders. Now I know some of you are saying, Therese, I can't get up. Don't worry. Just go as far as you can come up. This is really the hardest thing in Pilates, is trying to roll up from laying down all the way up. And if you've had any surgeries through your midsection, my ladies that have had C-sections, for instance, it's gonna be harder for you to grip hold of those deep ab muscles because the scar tissue gets in the way. So don't worry if you don't come all the way up. We're just going to our optimal point. So if you're healing your back, keep those feet on the floor. You can do as many of those as you want, because I know you love them. If you feel okay coming to a V set, this is again more spinal compression. We're gonna take our legs together as one leg, bring the arms up like we just did, but then instead of just coming up with the feet on the floor, we lift double legs and lower the legs, roll down your spine. So just a couple of things to mention here. Well, at least one thing to mention. In traditional Pilates, we try to lower the legs and the shoulders at the same time. But in more recent versions of Pilates, they have us lower the legs and then roll down the spine. It's a little safer. So we'll lower the legs and roll down the spine. If you're coming into that teaser position, keep the back nice and tall. Make sure you're blowing out through the mouth as you come up. And again, zip those legs together as the one leg. Shoulders away from the ears. Three more. Three, stick that landing. Two. Last one. Lower the legs and then roll it down. Fabulous. So it's getting a little late, so we're gonna rock up to sitting and move right into our push-ups. So traditionally, Joseph Pilates did what he called roll-down push-ups, where he rolled down from standing into a plank and did push-ups and then rolled back up. But we're going to just do standard push-ups today. If you don't want to do them on your hands on the floor, you can come up and find some wall space. I don't have a lot of wall space in my house, but if you have some wall space, you can lean against and you can do your push-ups right against the wall. Just make sure you're keeping the back nice and tall and that you're moving from the elbows and not from the pelvis. Or come to kneeling or full plank and do your push-ups there. If you need some cushioning under the knees, if you have a little towel or a blanket, you can fold it or double up your mat under your knees. We're stabilizing through the shoulders, keeping the neck long and that pelvis nice and tight. Inhale, lower your abs tight. Exhale, press out. And just your own breath, your own count. Pump them out. You got it. If you're on your knees, the knees are behind the hips. So make sure you're not in an all fours position because that won't work your body. Breathe. You got it strong. How we doing? You got it. There it is. Those are harder to do late at night, I gotta tell you. You probably went lower to the floor than I did at this hour. Bring it back when you're ready. Take a stretch for the shoulders. We can either sit, bring our arm across our chest, or if you feel okay laying on your head, take, thread the needle, right arm reaching under the left, turning the head to the right. Breathe. Float it back to center, other side. Left hand under the right, turn the head to the right, reach right across the room. Stretch it out. Nice work. Grab some water. We're gonna plank. We'll add some leg lifts and a little knee in and out to that too. If you're not comfortable in a plank, you can come to all fours and do the legs. So listen to your shoulders and elbows if you have any issues going on with that. So either on the elbows or on the hands, on the knees or on the toes if you're coming into a plank. Holding and breathing. Stabilizing. Making sure we're not holding our breath. Thank you.
got it. Try not to sag into our middle of our shoulders or into our pelvis. Making sure we're not looking at our chest or neck as long. How we doing? You're strong. So maybe come to hands if you're on your elbows. I'm going to do some leg lifts to the right. Again, you can be on all fours and do the same thing. Just lift it hip high. Inhale to prepare, exhale lift right leg. Squeeze the glutes, lengthen long out of the hip. Six more, five, four, three, two, one, other side. Six more, four, three, two, one. Switch legs, we're gonna bring right leg up, bring knee into chest. Exhale, pull it in, extend long. Squeeze the buttocks. Five, four, three, two, one. Switch legs. Six more. Five, four, three, two, and final time. Did it. Bring it down. Press back into a child's pose. So arms out longer. Stack your fists. Put your forehead on your fist. Knees open or closed. Whatever feels good. Feel super thirsty now. So we're gonna do a little prone back work. Be really careful here. You can skip this whole series if you have some issues with your back and you don't wanna put the extra strain on your back. Feel free to come up and just do a cat-cow stretch or hold your child's pose. You can also do these exercises on all fours. It's a little less strain on the back. So you can be right here, cat-cow. You could do some alternating arm and leg lifts there. Otherwise, come on down onto belly. And we'll take right arm and left leg lift for eight. Inhale to prepare, exhale lift. Again, we're squeezing the gluteals. We're blowing out through the mouth as we lift. Make sure you're using that breath to fire that deep ab muscle. It's gonna help protect your back. Four more. If it hurts, come right out of it. We don't work through pain. Two more. One, other side, eight. Seven, six, four more, three, two, one. Going into a thoracic lift, arms to a T with the palms down, looking down at the floor. Inhale first, exhale with the chest, just move to where your back wants to go with your breath. Make sure we're breathing. Blow out your birthday candle as you lift up. About four more, but to your own rhythm, so you can do more or less. Just making sure it's smooth and flowing. There's never jerking motion. Any kind of soccer start here. Be really careful. So maybe adding legs and an arm sweep to this is called a thoracic extension. You can stay with another set of those chest raises, or flip the arms so the palms are forward if the thumbs are up to the sky. Looking down at the floor, we'll inhale, exhale with the chest and the legs, sweep the hands to the hips. Squeezing the shoulder blades together, lengthening the spine, crown of the head forward, buttocks tightens as we come up. Nice and smooth. Four more. Three. Final time, well done. So either stacking our hands and putting the forehead on the back of the hands for some double leg lifts, or if you feel okay arching your back a little higher, pin place, the pointer fingers and thumbs together in front of us, dropping the shoulders down right on our forearms. Bringing the legs a little wider than the hips. Inhale first, exhale, lifting both legs. Squeeze the buttocks, lengthen. Blow out through the mouth as you're lifting up. Again, if it doesn't feel good, don't do it. Some people need a little extra cushioning under the hips, under the pelvis when they do that. If you feel like your bones are kind of pushing into a harder floor, it depends too what kind of floor you're on. If you're on carpeting, you might already feel a little cushion. So you could fold a little towel or something under the hips or double up your mat. Excuse me. And then bring the legs up, bring the heels towards each other and click the heels together slow for 8, 7, this is called heel beats, 6, squeeze your butt, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, double time at 2 sets of 8, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 8 more, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and last time, lower it down, shake it out, come on up, take it up for our cat-cow stretch, so we're in quadruped position. Nice wide starfish fingers or come onto fist for wrist. You can also sit and hold on behind your thighs if you don't want to be on all fours. Exhale, lifting the middle back up. Inhale, draw the heart through the arms. Flow it up. The seated version, so stay with that if you feel good. The seated version's right here. So if you're not good on your knees, if that hurts your knees, you can do the same exercises right here. Nice work. So we'll take a quad stretch and then we're gonna bring it round, stretch out our hips in our hip range of motion series, sideline. But coming onto our bellies with our right hand palm down. If you have a little towel or a Pilates ring or a yoga strap, you could use it here as well. You know, I forgot to tell you at the beginning of class. Bend the left knee, pressing the heel towards the buttocks. You can just press or we could reach back, either lasso that ankle with a yoga strap or a ring, or hold same side, hand to ankle. Forehead can rest right on the back of the hand, or if you want to arch your back, you can lift through the chest, lift through the thigh. Be careful there. More strain on our joints when we arch, keeping breathing. And then switching to the other side. So left, right knee comes in. Make sure you have that alignment with the knee and hip so our knee's not jutting out to the side. And then maybe reaching back to the ankle with a hand or a strap, a towel, or a Pilates ring. Staying low, the hand, left hand palm down, forehead on the hand, or arching up. Breathing. It's called a half bow in yoga. We call it half rocker in Pilates. Really pretty much the same. If you're doing a full bow or a full rocker, you can bring both knees in. Again, make sure they're not, the knees aren't going really far apart. They're as wide as the hip bones, maybe arching up. So the only difference is in Pilates, if you blow up through the mouth, you can rock. But you don't have to rock. Especially don't rock if you had something large to eat before you came to class. Come up, stretch out, child's pose. There's a lot of rocking and rolling kind of exercises in Pilates. We didn't do a whole lot of them today, but there are more. I would do it if you were in front of me in person. Maybe. Although you could roll like a ball, that's fine. To do on the computer, I think. So let's go sideline. We can either lay with our bottom hand under our head, or we can lengthen out and lay on our bicep. But bring the legs 2 feet in front. So we're not in a straight line. We're gonna bring those legs in front of us to take some load off the back. Bring the heels together. We call that Pilates V. So it's kind of like a little dancer in first position. We're gonna bring that top leg up and down with a pulse. Flex, flex up, point down. Exhale as you lift, inhale as you lower. I'm a little later than I realized here. Having too much fun. 4 more. 4. 3. 2. Last time. And then bring it up, give it a nice stretch. I like to circle my ankles, but you can just hold if you want. There's a lot of footwork in Pilates. Sometimes it's nice just to stretch it out. So this is called develop pair leg extension. We bring our heels together so our hips are open. Slide the top foot into the inner thigh, extend that leg, lower, and then squeeze the legs together, lift both legs. You can push into the floor to help that double leg lift if it, you know, it's better for you to do it that way. Bend, extend, lower, squeeze and lift two. The breathing's inhale, exhale. Really blow out through the mouth, especially on that double leg lift. That's our power move. You'll feel those lower abs fire. We'll feel that little side bend, working those obliques. We're nice and tight through that midsection the whole time. Just one more time. Nice work. And then bring it round to the other side because I'm running out of time. I'd like to keep you all day, but I can't, right? Head in your hand or on your long arm, feet 2 feet in front of you, kickstanding them, flex up, point down, exhale as we lift, inhale as we lower, just stretching it all out. So our powerhouse is nice and tight, so even when we're side-lying here, we're thinking about engaging the abdominals. We call that core centering in Pilates. It's one of the main principles of Pilates. Good job. And then bring it in, give it a stretch, pull it above or below the knee, maybe circle out the ankles, or just hold. If you have a strap, a ring, or a towel you want to put over your foot, happy to reach, feel free. I'm very short, so I don't have far to reach. And then bring it down, heels together, and we'll go into leg extension, our developpe. We're sliding the top foot to the inner thigh, extend the leg, lower, squeeze the inner thighs together, lift both legs. Inhale, exhale is the breathing. Push into the floor with the top hand if that helps with that double leg lift. Six more. Five. Four more strong. Three. Two. And final one. Then coming on to all fours. We're either gonna come to standing and lift and lower our heels, or if you feel okay coming upside down like a down dog, coming to hands and knees, crawling the toes under, lifting the hips up, pressing back into the heels and into the sitting bones. So we call this inverted V in Pilates. It's sort of like a down dog, pretty much just like a down dog, but we're more of an A-frame, so we're not pushing back into our sitting bones quite as much as you do in yoga. And then maybe lifting and lowering the heels here, or you could stand and do the same thing. It's just a calf raise. Four more. Four, three, two, last time. And then bending the knees, walking the hands towards the feet, come to forward fold, or if you're standing, just roll down to forward fold. Shaking your head yes, shaking no, come center, rolling over spine very slowly, taking eight counts to roll up, stacking our vertebrae one on top of the other, taking about eight counts to come there, realigning the spine, drawing the shoulders back and down, bringing the arms up, stay there, or maybe taking a gentle back bend. Coming center, inhale, exhale on the sides, reach up the sides, and press down the front, and give yourselves a great big round of applause. Excellent job, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me and doing your core work with me today. I hope you feel fantastic, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Have a great day.